Hi everyone, in this video we will learn how to implement automated security scanning of Docker images with GitHub Actions and Trivy. GitHub Actions is a continuous integration and continuous delivery, also known as CI/CD platform, that allows developers to automate their build, test, and deployment pipeline. If you would like a more in-depth explanation of GitHub Actions, I linked a YouTube tutorial I made in the description below. Trivy is a security scanner for containers, images, local directories within a file system, Git repositories, and other artifacts. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can automate container security scans with GitHub Actions. Please note that the code is available on GitHub and it is linked below in the description. In order to create a workflow with GitHub Actions, you need to define the workflow with a YAML file. The YAML file needs to be saved in a special directory. First, you need to create a directory called .github. Then within that directory, you need to create another directory called workflows. Within the newly created directory, I am going to create the YAML file for our workflow. I will name the file trivy_scan.yaml. Let us get into the code. First, I need to set a name for the workflow, and this will be displayed in the GitHub Actions interface. Next, we need to define our trigger event. A trigger event starts a new workflow within the GitHub action. In this case, there are two trigger events. A new workflow runs whenever a push occurs to the main branch. A new workflow will also run whenever a pull request targeting the main branch is created or updated. In terms of DevOps, it makes sense to run a security scanner when a push or pull request is executed because any potential vulnerabilities from the new code can be spotted and, if needed, be addressed quickly. Here I am going to define my job. A job defines a set of tasks to be executed. We have a single job here named build. The name gives a description of the job. I am going to scan the latest Docker image for Nginx using Trivy. The runs on key specifies the virtual environment that is used to generate the workflow. In my case, I am using Ubuntu 20.04, which is Focal Fossa. For our job, we have 9 underlying steps. The first step utilizes the actions checkout, a pre-built GitHub action provided by GitHub. This action clones our repository into the runner, which is a temporary virtual machine running Ubuntu Focal. By setting up the repository and the .git directory, this action enables us to make Git operations such as committing and pushing changes. This will be essential later in the workflow when we commit the Trivy scan results to the repository. The second step retrieves the current date using a bash command and stores it as an environment variable in GitHub env. This date will be dynamically appended to the Trivy output file's name, ensuring that each run generates a uniquely named file by date. The third step creates a directory within the runner's file system using a bash command. This directory will serve as the output location for the Trivy scan results for the current workflow run. We also have to create the directory within our original repository. The workflow creates the directory within the runner, but it does not create it within the original directory, which is why we need to create it here. The fourth step installs Trivy on the runner. We will run the typical steps when installing a package on a Ubuntu machine. First, we will update the apt package manager, next we will install curl, and finally we will use curl to download and run a bash script, which will install Trivy. The fifth step logs into the GitHub container registry using a personal access token, or PAT, stored in the secret GHCR PAT. This step is necessary because unauthenticated requests to the GitHub container registry are subject to stricter rate limits. By authenticating with a PAT, the runner has a higher rate limit and can pull images more reliably. I am going to switch over to my browser. I am going to show you how to generate a personal access token on GitHub and then use the personal access token within a GitHub repository. In the top right corner, I am going to select my profile. I am going to select settings. I will scroll down and at the bottom left, I have developer settings. I will select that. On the left, I am going to select personal access tokens and I am going to select a fine-grained token. I will select generate a new token. Now I can generate my token. I am going to name the token GHCR_PAT. By default, the logged in user is the resource owner. We have our expiration settings. This is how long the personal access token will last. By default, it's set at 30 days. For security purposes, it is best to set the expiration somewhere between 30 and 90 days. Having a personal access token with no expiration is a security risk. There is an option to set a description for the personal access token. I am going to say that this is for a GitHub action that is going to run a Trivy scan. For the repository access, I am going to leave the default as public repositories, and I will leave defaults for the remaining values and generate the token. We have our token here. I am going to copy the value from the clipboard. As always, be careful with sharing your token. Now that we have our token, I am going to go back to my repository where I am running my workflow. In my repository, I am going to go to the repository settings. On the left, I am going to select secrets and variables. I will select actions. I am going to create a new repository secret. I'm going to name the secret GHCR_PAT. When we reference our secret within the YAML file for the GitHub action, it will be based off of this name. And I am going to paste the value for the PAT within the secret body. I will add the secret. I am going to go back to my code editor to bring up the YAML file for our workflow. Step 6 downloads the Trivy vulnerability database. When Trivy scans a Docker image, it is going to reference this database. Step 7 runs the Trivy vulnerability scan. In this case, Trivy is scanning the latest Docker image for Nginx. For the scan, I want to output the results in a JSON format. I will exclude any vulnerabilities that do not have a fix available. I am going to scan for vulnerabilities in the base operating system of the image, such as Ubuntu Focal, and I am going to scan for vulnerabilities in application dependencies such as NPM or pip. I will have Trivy scan for vulnerabilities designated as high, medium, and low. Finally, after the scan is complete, the results will be output into the Trivy automation directory. Step 8 verifies that the results exist. The bash command prints out the content of the Trivy automation directory to check that the scan is there. Step 9, the final step, commits the changes to the original directory. An environment variable named GitHub token is created for authentication. The token allows the workflow to perform Git operations without requiring additional credentials. For the Git commands, the identity is configured. In this case, the identity for the workflow is the GitHub action itself. The scan results are staged and committed, then the commit is pushed to the main branch of the original repository. Now that we have our YAML file created for our workflow, let us push these changes into our GitHub repository. Once we push the changes to the GitHub repository, this will initiate the workflow we defined in our YAML file here. Within my git bash terminal, first I will run git add period, which will stage the changes in my current working directory. Next, I will commit the changes using git commit. I am going to write a descriptive message for my commit. Finally, I am going to push the changes using git push. I am going to go back to the repository to check out the workflow on GitHub. Within the repository, you will know a workflow is running if you have the name of the workflow followed by an orange dot. We can see the workflow for the Trivy scan is currently running. To view the workflow, I am going to go to the Actions tab. We can see we have a few workflows here. The workflow with the orange dot is currently running. I am going to select it. We have our job running for our workflow. We can click on it to see the underlying steps. We have our steps here. If there's a check mark, then we know that the step was executed. If there is an issue with a step, then a red X will appear next to the step, and a message with the error will print out here. Once a workflow has executed successfully, you will receive a green check. Let us go back into our repository and check out the output. I will select the GitHub Actions directory. Then the Trivy automation directory. We can see that we have a JSON file here. I will select it. And we can see here that we were successfully able to run the scan with Trivy on the Nginx Docker image. then save it within our repository. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. Within the description, I linked the documentation to GitHub Actions, as well as the documentation for Trivy and Docker. If you found the video helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also connect with me on LinkedIn, X, GitHub, Medium, and Odyssey. I also have a podcast called The Aspiring STEM Geek, which you can check out on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Audible, and iHeartRadio. Thanks again for watching and happy coding.